Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Good morning, everybody, and good afternoon. The Silk Road as a platform for enhancing cultural diversity, peace, and co-prosperity. Silk Road, the cradle of most civilizations. Silk Road University Network, SUN, is a well-known global initiative for promoting peace, harmony, tolerance among diverse cultures, and prosperity for all. Within a short period of 5 years, it has made a long way to its destination. Generally, roads are structures connecting areas of special importance to each other. One of the major phenomena in the history of the ancient world is the Great Silk Road. It had once been the main passage for commerce and cultural exchange between the East and the West for thousands of years. The Silk Road played an important role in connecting central China with Central Asia, Europe, and linking the ancient society, all of these related with sericulture as one of the characteristics of Chinese civilization, and had made a tremendous contribution to human civilization. The ancient Silk Road, linking China and Rome with the first bridge to mediate the transfer of commodities, as well as cultural and scientific idea between Asia and Europe. The road flourishing in particular between the 2nd century BC until the end of the 16th century AD. Considered as the oldest and longest trade routes, the Silk Road have indeed played a major role in the cultural, political, economic, religious, scientific, and artistic transformation that took place in major centers of civilization in different continents. The term Silk Roads referred to more than just the trade in silk between China and Rome over centuries. It stands for the exchange of ideas and think through trade, migration, pilgrimage, conquest, and diplomacy. It's worth to mention that some segment of the Silk Road played an important role in the development of site as a commercial and cultural center, such as Trabzon, Erzurum, and Pyort. These centers became scientific and artistic centers where peoples of different ethnic and cultural background could meet and debate. On a particular level, merchants had to learn the language and customs of the countries they traveled through in order to negotiate successfully. It's important to mention that the history of the Silk Road shows that civilization thrives with openness and nation prosper through exchange. The Silk Road has played an important role of the cultural history and the interaction between civilization. A number of ancient heritage sites still remain along the road and are testament to the cultural and commercial activities that flourished in ancient times. Due to the environmental factors, heritage sites have been continuously damaged, have collapsed, and even destroyed in the past thousands of years. The situation tells us that taking protective measures should be an urgent task for heritage preservation. Cultural exchange can become generalized between neighboring and mutually dependent cultures. The Silk Road represents a common trading framework that ensured relatively peaceful relations between neighboring peoples and fostered a genuine respectiveness to difference, which benefited the cultural development of the population concerned and enabled significant cultural transfer to take place across geographical areas. As the Silk Road crossed some of the most populated countries, which experienced important development of science and technology, it contributed to shape the dynasty of our society. Thus, the Silk Road can be considered as an early form of the globalization of trade, science, technology, and ideas. However, for those working in political science, sociology, linguistics, marketing, or tourism, to name a few, the Silk Road has become a key analytical factor for understanding the connection of the 21st century. The Silk Road has become attractive because of the nostalgia of ancient time, of another way of interacting, exchanging, and sharing. For historians of the 20th century, the Silk Road is also a valuable resource for understanding the shifting nature of East-West relations and the politics of a cultural sector cooperation in relation to colonialism, world wars, and the Cold War. Today, everyone, it seems, is claiming rights to their share of the Silk Road. Today, with the newly achieved independence of many Middle Asian nations, new opportunities have arisen to utilize the ancient Silk Road. This development also meant a convergence of the East and the West. Unfortunately, there are been a number of shameless anti-civilization acts that make it harder for us to be proud of the Silk Road today, because people cannot travel fairly and safely through it. As a result, it is important to solve this problem by announcing some issues. First, we should work together as one team, one body, to achieve our goal by exchanging expert services, scholar, and professional between countries. Second, we should help our students for future leaders to have safe world by connecting people and cultures around them by reclaiming the heritage of the Silk Road. Third, through university-wide volunteer work, we can heal the human suffering in the Silk Roads by educational and academic program exchange event. Fourth, finally, through the theme of this year's General Assembly, we have the chance to raise our voice together, demanding for peace and co-prosperity along the Silk Roads. We deserve security and a good life away from war and conflict between nations. We hope the sun will appeal as a global peace initiative to transfer the ancient Silk Roads to a peace road in the 21st century that promote coexistence, cultural exchange, and inclusive prosperity. Thank you for listening.